Namaste YouTube, welcome to Enoma. We are going to give our reaction to Do I Remember a Life by Michael Kiske. And this is a Patreon request. It is one of our patrons who is very, very nice, courteous and kind and very nice to deal with. And I'm not really sure.
The patron's name is Emerald Dawn.
Yeah.
We'll put up a screenshot of our patron's name right now.
Yes.
And I believe this is one of Emerald Dawn's favorite male singer. So I'm really keen to listen to him because I've never ever heard of Michael Kiske before. So as a counselor, we've got a small background from Emerald Dawn. It is a song about a friend's suicide. I believe both Michael Kiske and the friend whose name is Iogo was members of a very popular rock band called Halloween. So they had to part ways at some point of time after 6-7 years of being with this band. And the other friend who this song is written about ended up going into depression and ultimately committing suicide.
Yeah.
So this song, this lyrics of this song, and this song was created, dedicated to the friend of Michael Kiske, the fellow member of Halloween who committed suicide. So I'm really, really interested as a counselor and therapist, I'm really keen on giving my take on this, analyzing this, listening to this. So let's get started.
The title makes
sense. And I think same goes for you.
The title makes sense to me now. Do I remember a life? As in somebody.
Somewhere by the beach.
I once was a blue-eyed, I once dreamed I was free, I once dived in a life spent in sea, and heard the voice of the priest. I once heard the angels singing the song of the cross. There was no fear, no doubts in our hearts, no soul could ever. Pray to the heavens above. I reached for the sky full of love. I waited the luminous sign to hear what's heard by the purest is mine.
Together hearts full of love. I
Nice. Phenomenal voice, it really hits those high notes so beautifully.
Wow, this was an amazing song. This is the kind of song which only an aching heart can sing. It was that heartfelt. It was that, that emotional.
Yeah, I mean, this is a great tribute to pay to a friend who's passed away.
Hmm.
So much emotion, so much concern in the voice, so much
pain.
Yeah, there was pain in the voice. I mean, his voice is amazing. His, the way he stretched those high notes, it's never easy to stretch high notes. It was awesome. It reminded me of Steelheart, the song, you know, sung by Dennis Gonzalez, covered by him. Wow, this was awesome. Michael Kiske has one of the best voices I've heard in rock music, to be honest. I once was a blue-eyed, I once dreamed I was free. I once dived in a life-spending sea and heard the voices of the priest. I once heard the angels singing the song of the cross. There was no fear, no doubts in a heart. No soul could ever get lost. Here I think the talk is about baptism and Holy Communion, if I'm not mistaken.
Mm-hmm.
You know, when the baby just enters the world, a blue-eyed baby,
yeah.
The priest is baptizing the baby. If I'm not mistaken, this is with reference to that. Mm-hmm. Because I once dived in a life-spending sea. But there's a lot of references from the Bible here and from the Catholic faith. So I think it may have references to baptism and Holy Communion in this verse. What is your take on the song and about his voice?
This was, this is a song where you can never miss. You can never miss. If it is playing, you cannot just pass, you have to stand and listen to it. And the way it is sung, the way Michael Kiske, this is an introduction to him for us. And thanks to Emerald Dawn who's done it. This is an amazing, amazing song. It is so, as I said, the pain in his heart can be heard through his voice in this song. And that's very important. When you make something for a purpose, it should be, you know, serving the purpose. And
I love the sounds of the beach. You know, it would seem like the beach, the waves, the breeze, the beach birds.
Yeah.
And it continued off and on at the background throughout, I think. If you really raise the volume, I think we could get it throughout the song. And I love the way it ended with the piano.
Yeah,
it was
very
so
beautiful.
So soothing, so beautiful.
I also like the flute, use of the flute towards the end. It was going on. Simultaneously, while the song was going on, it was a beautiful way of singing.
Yeah,
the
second verse, I prayed to the heavens above. I reached for the sky full of love. Awaited the luminous sign to hear what's heard by the pure restless mind. Beautiful words describing the love, the pain, the anguish, missing somebody. You know, now you can see me return. I look for the priest to make me learn. Will I still remember the past? Will I remember the past? Make me return to the best. Wow. It's really a heartfelt song. I mean, you really can play this. I would love if I had a friend who would write me a poem like this, even.
That
forget
would be
about
a
song.
For anyone.
Write me a poem like this and sing it on my funeral day. My loved one, a friend, a sibling.
Someone
anybody.
To leave behind,
wow.
Yeah.
This would be what an amazing, amazing way to leave this world, to go to the heavens above. Wow. I mean, I don't really know. I mean, you know, it's. We live in such a big, big world that we can never, ever, in one lifetime, listen to all the music that's there. And that's a really sad part for me, because you miss out on such great singers like Michael. You miss out on such phenomenal musicians that were part of this song and part of other songs requested by Emerald Dawn and other patrons who have been so loyal, so courteous, so kind. And they are so inspiring to me specifically as a counselor and music lover, because it connects, it helps piece things together in my life, it helps enrich my life, and I'm sure it helps enrich the lives of people who come to our reactions. Do I remember a life in the dark age of time? I remember those lines very well. I hear it call in my dreams. Maybe I was not alone. Maybe I called friends my own. Together hearts full of love. What is your take on these first four verses?
This one for me is it shouting that the friend was in a lot of distress and going through a very tough time, and he could feel it, and he knew they both were in the same, going through the same phase, similar phase.
There's so many great, talented together human beings who have ended their lives due to depression. And for all of them, I would like to share a few little tips. If any of you are suffering from any kind of depression, there are different phases, different terminologies for it. So if any of you are suffering from depression and you cannot afford to visit a psychotherapist or counselor like me, or you cannot afford to get professional help, I will give you a few pointers to get started. And if you have any friend, family member, peer, neighbor who's suffering from depression, please share these pointers with them, because this is my professional suggestions to you for free in this reaction. Because I really feel for all the losses we have made of great talented human beings. Robin Williams comes to mind, Chester Bennington comes to mind, Anthony Bourdain comes to mind, and here we have one more person, the close friend and confidant and member of the band Halloween of Michael Kiske, who passed away due to suicide. So there are a lot of people who went through depression, and there are a few tips I can give. I'll start with the first one, music. Music therapy is one of the best ways to overcome depression. Listen to music, especially melodious music, serene music, new age music like Kitaro, Yanni, Mehdi, classical music like Beethoven, Mozart, Tchaikovsky, Andreas Vivaldi, and so many other philharmonic orchestras all over the world. Listen to nice soft music, because that is the first way you can help tackle and overcome depression. Second is art therapy. Art can be various forms, painting, sculpture, music too is part of art therapy. Drawing, sketching, writing a poem, writing things in a journal, all that comes in art therapy. Express your emotions, give an outlet to them, all this grief, the emotions, the confusion inside, give it a window to escape into the atmosphere around you. I know my heart says this truth, maybe it was me and you. I got to return to the wind. The world is never our home. Somewhere I left friends alone. Can someone show me the way? Do I remember a life? So the third part that you can do to overcome depression, because I think this will help a lot of people coming to this reaction. It will help a lot of others that they know. If they pass these simple tips, they're really simple. And they're mostly for free or cost minimal to do them in your daily life. Music therapy, art therapy. Next is nature therapy. Like the sounds infused into the radio, into the song, the morning birds, the waves, the breeze, nature, Mother Nature, the first song we react to do, the second song, Mother Gaia. Of Emerald Dawn, talks about Mother Nature. Yeah, Stratovarius' song. So similarly, nature therapy can really, really help you cure depression, if cure stress, cure anger. It can literally melt anger away, nature therapy. So go on a vacation or take breaks near nature, head to a garden in and around your home, close to your home, head to a nice park where there's a lot of greenery, a lot of flowers, go to a nearby beach, to the sea, enjoy the breeze, enjoy the sounds of the waves, the birds in the sky, the breeze, the wind, everything. Feel it, sense it, hear it, and that is nature therapy at its best. It's free. Mother Nature is for free. There was once a mystery that now sings in my heart. The fire in my veins talks so loud about the past, about the place where the love for our heart starts. We once moved through the cold fields, strong and safe, led by the gods. The voices in the wind sang the children to sleep. Free spirits look clear through the dark. What beautiful words by Michael Kiske. Just wonderful, just so profound and deep and meaningful. We can never understand or give meaning to a song like this. So I'm not even going to try in this reaction. I thought I could, but you can't give meaning. You cannot interpret this, because you have to have been in his position, his shoes, when he wrote this for his friend who passed away. You have to have been there, and I haven't been there. So I will never be able to interpret it, even as a counselor, what he felt. So what I can best do is, what we both can best do as counselors and human beings, is to give you a few pointers to tackle anger, stress, depression, grief. Because that is what causes all these things to happen. I'm sure the multitude of these emotions has led to the death of this friend of Michael. So what is one tip you could give, one or two tips right now, to help people cure their depression or stress or handle it better?
People may not want to follow this one, but this is the best one I have thought, and nobody else, you know, suggests you to do it. But I would say, if you think you are going through depression, if you have matched the symptoms and the signs in you, and there are so many websites and so many places where they are given clear signs of depression, and you think you're going through one and you don't want to be in it and you want to get out of there, the one thing that may work like a magic pill would be, take a vacation and go to the countryside. Most people who are living in the countryside, villages, they never go through depression. Most of the people, because they have big families living over there under one roof, you go and find a space there where you can relax, where you can connect with people, where you can see the simplicity of life. You just need to take a break from what is going on around you and need to get into somewhere where you can ease your pain and ease yourself. And that would be my biggest tip that anybody can follow, and I think this will work.
I pray to the heavens above, I reach for the sky full of love, I wait for the luminous sign to hear what's heard by the pure restless mind. I see the 12 around the one. I love these words, the pure restless mind, yeah, and 12 around the one. The mystery truth to carry on, a fight against the strong earth kings, the sun god's light we had to bring. Another tip you could share about this, about how to deal with depression.
The next
we've
one.
Shared so fast very quickly, because I will not be able to put up screenshots maybe that quickly, yeah, before our reaction is online. So I might add it in the description, the points that we have mentioned, the main points. So first was, as I said, music therapy. Next was art therapy. Okay. Third was nature therapy. Fourth was take a vacation or break in the countryside.
Not on, yeah, a, you know, fancy location. Don't try to go for a fancy, yeah, location, because the people you're going to be meeting over there are all coming there to just throw money or something like that. They have their own fantasies and their own fancies, and yeah, you won't fit in well over there.
While you think about the next one or two tips, and while I also think about them, do I remember a life in the dark age of time? I hear it calling my dreams. Maybe I was not alone, maybe I called friends my own, together hearts full of love.
As I was saying, the fancy vacation won't serve the purpose. And the next tip of mine would be, start staying busy. The maximum time that you can spend doing something or the other that you may like at that time. There are, you know, there are mood swings. There are times when you feel empty. There are times when you don't feel like doing anything. A person going through depression, they don't want to do anything. They don't want to listen to anything around them. They are just fed up. They are just done with things. They are just hopeless at times. They just don't know where to start. Where will be that beginning? They don't know. But you have to force yourself and start staying busy, start staying around people, even if you have to force this one. You have to force yourself to get out.
Or start out with a hobby, your small, yeah, hobby, like any of the other
just
tips you mentioned,
busy.
Writing, craft, woodmanship, I mean being a...
Any hobby
you under the sun. And that's why YouTube really helps out, because you can
so
find
ideas,
hundreds,
yeah,
of hobbies to keep yourself busy. And the next tip is something that I just did while she was narrating, meditation. One of the best ways to overcome practically any problem under the sun, I repeat that, any problem under the sun, in my opinion, as a professional counselor, therapist, soft skills trainer, life coach, and human being, I would say there is no greater medicine on this planet than meditation. Meditation is the best medicine. This is my quote that I've shared with my clients and students for years on end, and I'm sharing it with you in this reaction. Meditation is the best medicine. You just sit there, lay down, close your eyes and just let your mind go blank. Focus on your sounds of the breathing. Breathe in, hold, breathe out. Just do that for a few minutes, anytime during the day. Find a quiet place in your home if you can, in your surroundings if you can, in your office if you can. Just lay back, rest back, close your eyes and breathe in. Hold for a couple of seconds, breathe out. That will instantly make you feel better. You can literally sense me feeling better right now. I know my heart says the truth. Maybe it was me and you. I got to return to the wind. The world is never our home. Somewhere I left friends alone. Can someone show me the way? Do I remember a life? And this is where he, I think, is talking a lot about the, you know, the feelings he's going through after his friend passed away.
The regrets,
the guilt, maybe the remorse, a bit of remorse can be sensed in these lines.
Resentment.
He wish he could return, he wish he could go back to those times, he wish he could have helped him.
Because the best thing
that we can do as human beings is to help another human being. The greatest job on the planet is not the job that me and you do, but it is helping other human beings survive, thrive, live better, be happier. I'll repeat that. The greatest job of any human being, the purpose of us being on planet Earth, no matter which religion we believe in, no matter which religion we do not believe in, those things don't matter. Those are petty things. But at the end of the day, the purpose of every human being is to help another human being, a fellow human being, without discrimination of skin, color, race, creed, gender, and all those things that actually differentiate us right now on the planet.
Right.
So we should help fellow human beings. That's the greatest service that we can do to our fellow beings and to everyone around the planet. And it goes so well. I've always seen that if I help even one person through my reaction of this, and she helps one person. So if together we help two people who watch this reaction, overcome their depressions, overcome their problems, live better, be happier, those two people will end up helping two more people. Those two people will help up ending two more people. And slowly, in maybe 20 years down the line, us two helping two people, together we would have helped 2 million people live better lives. And this is a formula that I genuinely believe in. I've seen it with my audiobooks. I've seen it in my lectures. I've seen it in my life coaching sessions. I've seen it in my corporate seminars. I focus on helping a few people at a time. One person who benefits through this reaction, whether it's by the lyrics of this song or by my tips and her tips to overcome depression, one person helped, two people helped, 2 million people will be helped by us if we just carry on the good work. And that is what I love about reacting to things. It gives me an opportunity, thanks to YouTube, this incredible platform, to showcase my talents, not just as a human being or a music lover or a reactor. We are not mere reactors on this platform. We are way beyond ordinary reactors. We are special in our own way because we want to help people beyond the reaction. We want to make people happier. We want to serve others because in doing so, we become happier. We are doing a great service to ourselves and we become better people. We live better lives. God showers us with bountiful blessings and gives us better lives. So if you can, I beg you, I literally beg you, if you can, and if you believe in our professionalism as counselors and reactors beyond the reaction, please take those tips that we have shared with you, those 6-7 tips that both of us have shared. We will try and mention all of them in the description, and if possible, put up a screenshot too right now in the video so you can revise them. Maybe we can't time it well due to time constraints, and we are counselors and trainers by day, YouTube reactors by night. So we do not have much time because we do have a family, we do have our own things to do, and this doesn't put food on the table. No matter whether we have 30 or 40 patrons, we will never be able to put food on the table and pay all our bills thanks to reactions alone. So we have to do other things, and that's why it's important that you get the message right at the end of this reaction. There are different ways that we have given. There may be many more. Sports is another. Conversation is another. Talking with friends. Psychotherapy, of course. Professional ways are there, which cost money. Sometimes there are great organizations around the world which offer free counseling, free psychotherapy services, and hats off to them for doing that great, great service, because there's no better job in the world than helping other human beings live better lives or helping them overcome their daily problems. So that is what I feel. Lives like that could be saved. This song would not need to, would need have to be existed if that friend didn't die.
Yeah.
So if the person had got help at the right time, he would be perhaps alive today, singing, guitaring, drumming.
Yeah.
I don't know what he did. Yeah. So, art therapy, music therapy, nature therapy, take a break in nature, countryside, take a walk in the park, at the beach, spend time with friends, loved ones, quality time, spend time in meditation, stay busy, and you know,
and most important,
drop in more often on our reactions, because our reactions always, always, always go beyond the reaction. Our purpose is not just to react. Our purpose is to make people who watch our videos live a better life. Because in doing so, we live a better life. Because what goes around comes around.
Yes.
So we do not want bad karma coming our way.
And in the end, if nothing really works for you and you think things are getting out of control and you really don't seem to get out of situation, please, you know, go for a expert or professional help. Take that step. It helps. There are times when you need medication. Other things may not work. You have to go take an appointment, go to a psychiatrist or somewhere and get help. Because when you go in time, there is a lot of options that you have to, you know, change things. Turn things around for you. And life is always beautiful if you are in a great state of mind.
Yeah.
You just have to maintain that state of mind. That's all. It's all about our mind, how it perceives life. There are times that we don't see the good things, and there will be times that we will be again able to see good things, offer good things, enjoy good things, and that's all you all want to achieve. That's all we all need to achieve, nothing else.
I would like to end this reaction by saying a little prayer for all of us. And for the loved ones who passed away, like Michael's friend, a little prayer. May God watch over them, and may they find help and overcome the problems that they are facing. No one can understand what they go through but God. So I do hope that they can be saved and they do not take drastic steps like this and ending their life. May God watch over all of them. Thank you for being with us. And if you did not like this reaction, we completely understand. I completely understand. The dislike button is there for you to hit the dislike button. But if you found this reaction helpful, do consider supporting our work or continue supporting our work if you are already a patron. Because it helps us make videos like this more often. Else one day we'll have to stop it. So thank you, and let's end this.
Thanks for watching.